Welcome to Inside Working Wardrobes. I have the pleasure of introducing you to my good colleague, Ashley Vulcan-Varable. Ashley, how are you?
Wonderful. Thank you, Jerry.
Thank you for agreeing to be one of our roving reporters for Inside Working Wardrobes. One of the reasons I wanted Ashley to be interviewed is that she's our Director of Client Services. So she is looking at so many of the programs that we're doing with our clients. So, Ashley, you've been with us for over 8 years.
Yes.
Can I just take you back to the first year? Tell us, who were you 8 years ago?
Wow, I was truly a completely different person. I was introduced to the organization by a former board member named Harold, who was also a customer of mine at Pete's. And I was transitioning in between positions and knew that the retail world really wasn't where I belonged, and I wanted to give back and do more.
So you have a long history of giving back that comes from your family. Can you give us just a small little view of who you were as a child and how what those experiences were that your parents shared with you and how that informed the Ashley that we know today?
I spent a lot of my childhood working at different organizations to give back. And one of those was the Salvation Army. In the dead of winter, we would go to downtown Omaha and serve meals to families. And there were children running out in the snow with no shoes, no jackets. And so we would literally give everything we had, sometimes our shoes even, to support these families and make sure that they were able to survive in those cold winter nights.
So I can only imagine having that as a message when you're 8, 9, 10 years of age. Here you are now, Director of Client Services at Working Wardrobes, working with clients and working with staff every day. Tell us what that background meant to you in the work that you're doing now.
It really gave me a foreshadowing almost of this work that I've been doing for so long, and provided me early on that empathy and that compassion for individuals who didn't grow up the same as others, and to really be able to give my best and do my best work in serving our clients to get them onto the right side of the digital divide.
So let's talk about the clients, because you oversee our Career Success Institute. You oversee our program called CSEP and reentry. So let's take them one at a time. What does CSI offer to clients?
Our Career Success Institute, or CSI, offers the unemployed, the underemployed, really anyone in the community who is in need of workforce readiness services, the opportunity to engage with us through virtual workshops, one-on-one career coaching, job search assistance, resumes, practice interviews, really anything that someone asks for, we're able to deliver.
So then the Career Success Institute is sort of the foundation of everything, and all programs tap into those services.
Yes, CSI is our umbrella program that oversees or encompasses all of the other programs that we offer.
So how does the Reentry to Success program tap into that?
So our Reentry to Success program focuses on serving justice involved, which the organization has done for a number of years. But I've really fallen in love with this population and with our partners at the Sheriff's Department at probation to be able to provide employment services for individuals who have not been in the workforce for a number of years with maybe a little bit of a colored background.
So where you have staff that are specifically trained to work with this population, what's the end game? What do you want to have happen with the clients that have been formerly incarcerated?
I mean, our end game is always to hear them say, I got the job,
right?
And the power of a paycheck. But for every client, it's a different story. And for some, employment isn't the answer. So some may go back to school, pursue higher education. Others are battling literacy issues and dealing with things at a slower pace. So for us, we really want to meet those clients where they're at and be able to provide however many services they need.
Which I think is just remarkable. I mean, it's not one size fits all. It's what does the client need? And that's really what draws us. So you also oversee a program that helps underserved and seniors who are low income. So tell us about this CSEP program.
So CSEP is a program or a contract that we have in partnership with the Office on Aging. And it really focuses on those lower income seniors who are 55 and over who are looking to get back into the workforce. And that program really looks at providing them with job training at host site agencies that are nonprofits or government work to be able to retrain and retool their skills to get back to work.
So you've obviously talked with and served a lot of clients in the past 8 years. Can you share with us some significant win that really moved your heart?
Absolutely. So one of our first major success stories in reentry years ago was with a young woman that I will call Sam. And Sam had spent a lot of time in and out of jail and sat in the front of the class, always wanted to mentor the other individuals that we were serving, had lost custody of her daughter, was fighting drug addiction issues. And when Sam was released, she came right over to Working Wardrobes, enrolled in our customer service training, just really engaged in the work. Sam received a job with a friend of ours at a local dry cleaners, and then moved up 6 months later to be the assistant manager of that store. We've kept in contact. She now has a car, has an apartment, is engaged, and has regained custody of her daughter.
Okay, honestly, does it get any better than that? So I'm gonna talk a little bit more with Ashley. You can hear more of our conversation if you click on the link below, because there is a lot more that Ashley wants to talk about. Thank you for joining us for Inside Working Wardrobes.